see, we have to feed our animals ahead of time. Okay.
The government will rest on his sons.
Was the very first Christmas, and all through the town, not a creature was stirring, there was not a sound. The moon shining bright in the heavens so high, gave the luster of midday to the Bethlehem sky. The animals were nestled in warm, cozy places with looks of contentment on each of their faces. and Mary and Joseph, some tired from the road, had just settled into a humble abode. To a Bethlehem stable, they traveled with care, but knew that their baby, Boone, a boy, soon would be there. And then in a stable, a baby's first cry, peace on earth, goodwill, redemption is nigh. He had not a crib, but a manger instead. The tiny new baby laid down his sweet head. Mary looked down at his cute little nose and silently counted 10 fingers and 10 toes. As shepherds kept watch on a small nearby hill, their sheep were all silent and sleeping still. When suddenly in the sky there arose such a sight, one angel, then many, appeared in the night. The heavens rejoice as their story unfurled. A baby, a savior, had been born to the world. So the shepherds arose to search for the place to get a close look at the baby's sweet face. Then out of the east, there came royalty whose mission was finding the Savior, you see. When they finally found the baby they sought, gold, frankincense, and myrrh were the gifts that they brought. The wise men bowed down and praised his sweet name, since all those heard would rejoice that he came.
The three believed without a doubt, saw a guiding light, found him in a lonely place, knew he was divine. Wise men stood up for him.
John 3:16.